Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who is one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff uses the tools on the jaw panel to control how the cheeks and chin deform when the jaw opens.
Okay, and you can also kind of do the same process with the jaw itself. It doesn't have a region associated with it. There's no real kind of jaw region, but it has its own tab with these controls. And there's several different things you can do. The one that corresponds roughly to what we were doing on the regions is the deflation. And that, if you set up a pose that's roughly, you know, a wide open mouth extreme, you can do the same thing on the deflation ease-in curves. So you can kind of crank this up, and it's not where you want it at this point, but you can at least set your boundaries here. So crank that up pretty good, and do the same thing with this slider. Drag it in until it stops having a noticeable effect. So around in there, probably. Adjust your ease ends a bit. So now you at least know what that range is going to be, and this is your extreme on this control. So now you can go in there and start tuning those individual deflation curves to look like you want without worrying about them getting pushed too far if someone goes nuts, because if someone pulls this down further, it won't deflate anymore now since you set that range. So it's a good thing to do first before you get into a lot of curve adjusting. Okay, so I'll just start back at the top here on this one. Now that you've kind of got that taken care of, you can start to adjust kind of how much fattening happens. Of course, that's going to vary from character to character. On a young female like this, you don't want it to be too extreme, so just enough to kind of hold that volume and not, you know, bulge out too much. And then you have a curve associated with that as well, and that curve that corresponds to roughly one corner of the jaw on the zero key, and on the right key the other side of the jaw. And this middle key corresponds to the center of the chin. So you can control where the fattening happens along that line under the chin, or under the jawline. So if I take this center point and reduce it, you can see it reduces mostly underneath the chin. And if I just take these and jack them up, you're going to see, if I turn this up so you can see it more, so you can see that affects more along the corners. And then you can add keys to this curve to control it more accurately. So let's just put these back where they were. So we'll just leave that at that setting for now. And then a deflation is a separate kind of function. That's what's giving you this kind of odd-looking dent and deformation here. And if you remember, in the fitting stage, you had two curves in the center that you adjusted for the jaw lines, and those correspond to this upper jaw and lower jaw deflation curve. So if I go to the upper jaw, you can see it's set up in a profile already. And again, this is one side of the face, the other side of the face, and the middle. Whoops. This corresponds to the middle of the chin, and this is that line from temple to temple, basically, following the jawline. So if I take, just for an experiment, if I take these two points and really pull them down, you can see where that deformation happens. So that kind of gives you the effect of your jaw hinge protruding a bit when you open it very wide. You don't want it that wide, obviously, so you can start to kind of play with those and see how that starts to show up. So you can move these in different, you know, spaces so that it happens a little further down the jawline, or keep them higher up toward the temples. So you can edit these however you want and move keys and add keys. And then if you take these two and pull those way down, you can see where that effect happens. So the closer you get to the center, the closer to the middle of the chin you also get. So you can kind of start to map it out once you understand that. So let's work on the lower jaw first, and I'll just take these and kind of help that jaw keep its volume there a bit. And kind of get that back to where it needs to be on the edges. You might even want to pull those in a bit so that keeps its volume a bit better. Now you may go in here and do this and realize it's just all too much, and instead of trying to go through the curve and lessen, you know, one key and another, you do have global amount curves and sliders here. So you can kind of work at a extreme level and dial it in later, which is what I tend to do, just so I can see what I'm doing a little easier. Keep the bumps and cavities pretty extreme. So let's just say that's how we want it, and you can, you know, adjust forever in here until you get it just right. Then you can go back to the upper jaw and say you want the temples to dent more. You can add a point or move this point back. I guess you'd want to actually use this. You can actually cause a, you know, concavity to happen there when the jaw opens on the temple. And you can, again, control those kind of cheekbone or the jaw hinge protruding when you open the jaw. And you can control, you know, how much hollowing happens in the cheek when she opens really wide, which that's too much. And again, you can spend a lot of time in here if you want to and add a lot of curves and keys and kind of get this shaped exactly like you want it. So let's say that's good. And then you can go to your deflation ease in curves and adjust that amount to be exactly what you want. So you can really, really distort her a lot with that. So let's just say we want something like that. Maybe a little strong on the back side here. So I'm going to go to that lower jaw. Pull some of that back out. And you can probably add a little back in now. So it's got some of it fixed. So the last thing in here is sliding. You have sliding profile curve and ease-in curves. And this just kind of controls the amount of a skin sliding effect around the jaw. And if I take this from 0 to 1, you can see how that happens. I don't adjust this too much usually. It's generally okay. But same thing applies. You have the sliding curve where you can control how much sliding happens along the jawline, and then a mount slider and a profile curve or a ease-in curve as well. So we'll just leave those there. And it's got the jaw working pretty well.